The world's first golf balls were made of wood, then leather balls filled with feathers. Fast forward to today, and it might seem like golf ball technology has plateaued. But in reality, some of the smartest minds in materials, engineering, and aerodynamics are hard at work improving what, at first glance, seems like the most everyday of objects. We visited Callaway's R&D department to ask, why is it so hard to design a better golf ball? When you're hitting a long shot, you're actually using a different part of the ball compared to when you're hitting a short shot.
When you think about the game of golf, you've got multiple shots. The first one starts at the tee. You're actually impacting it with a lot of normal force, causing the ball to deform quite a bit. So the soft core is something that really plays into those long shots. When you get closer to the green, and we make that core really firm, what we're doing is we're increasing the spin, and that's what gives you that really good spin around the green, allows the ball to stop where you want it once it gets to the green. So those are the challenges where we want to make something that's soft and fast. We want it to be low spin off the driver, high spin around the green.
The multi-core ball was created to combine both attributes into one ball. Two cores allow for something called spin separation, a soft inner core for the long game and a firm outer core for the short game. With the advent of these new multi-layer balls, it sparked a craze. They showed up on the PGA Tour and revolutionized how amateurs approached their game. But then progress kind of stopped.
Coupling phenomena is really interesting in golf ball design because there are particular things in physics that are really hard to separate. So every time we add a new material into a golf ball, you have to pull something else out. And that's sometimes a bummer because when you pull something else out, you're pulling out a different performance attribute that you'd like to keep in.
You have a ball that's only 1.68 inches diameter and only 45.9 grams. So there's only so much room to put so much weight.
In order to improve overall performance of the golf ball, Callaway engineers found it important to increase the inner core size and added more soft material, in theory, helping to optimize the balance of long and short game benefits. However, because of the zero-sum nature of the challenge, a larger inner core resulted in a smaller, thinner outer core. The durability of this dual core, its ability to withstand the high-impact forces of a driver hit, was at its threshold because of the differences in firmness between the two core layers. The existing dual core design couldn't advance much further. That is, until scientists discovered graphene.
When one of my chemists came to me with the idea of graphene, it was a little outside the box. Graphene is one of the strongest, if not the strongest, material in the world. It's extremely light, it's extremely flexible. It's essentially a two-dimensional material. What that means, it's a carbon-based molecule, but it's one atom thick. It was discovered in 2004. The two scientists that discovered it won the Nobel Prize for it in 2010.
Callaway is the only golf ball manufacturer using graphene. What graphene allows them to do is make a firmer, thinner outer core, while increasing the size of the inner core at the same time. That means that you get all the short game benefits of a firm core, plus the long game benefits of a soft, large inner core.
We test a lot of things here and a lot of new materials here, and you don't see something so obviously better.
When it comes to designing golf balls, there's a lot of compromises you have to make. We're trying to fight those compromises. When we started using graphene, it really took the burden off a lot of that, and it really gave us a lot of the pros that we're looking for without a lot of the cons. And I think the results speak for themselves. You know, Chrome Soft is a great performing product from tee to green, and people have really seen the benefits of graphene in it.